아, 미그레트 두산 사우스 제 이름은 컨스턴스입니다. 만나서 반갑습니다.
어, 와우. My name is June. Nice to meet you.
So today we are here to talk about a few things about Korea. What to expect when you move to Korea. Some of the things that's happening here that a lot of foreigners don't know about. So we're gonna cover lots of different topics. Are you excited?
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
He's not excited. He's scared.
I'm excited, but yeah.
He's very nervous. So we're gonna start out talking about moving to Korea.
Yeah.
Recently, I watched a YouTube video where a girl is talking about different stuff in Korea, mm-hmm. and I saw a lot of comments where. A lot of foreigners like, oh, I can't wait to move to Korea. Oh my gosh, Korea is like the number one place I want to go. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, they do not know what to expect. Because it's not that great, people. It's okay.
There are many great people.
Korea is okay, people. So today we're going to give you the real truth.
I'm great, people.
No, it is great. But we're going to talk about things that you guys don't expect to experience here. So we're going to cover how to prepare your move to Korea. You already live here, so you don't have to prepare.
I had to prepare to come here. Yeah.
And
what did you prepare?
So as a woman, there's a lot of things that I need to bring with me because I know I couldn't find here in Korea.
Oh.
And as a black woman, there's a lot of things I cannot find here.
Oh.
So one of the things is makeup.
Yeah.
Because the makeup here is not going to have my skin tone.
Oh.
So that's something that I would say, bring your own makeup if you're dark skin, because you're not going to get it here.
Oh, I didn't know that. Yeah.
You didn't? Well.
Yeah, of course. I cannot know.
So makeup, I think, is very important. So I bought my own foundation that matched my skin color because I know I couldn't get it here.
Oh.
Another thing is hair, especially for black women.
Uh-huh.
Our hair is very different texture. So we have to take care of it in a certain way.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to bring a lot of my hair products with me because Korea is not going to have the products I need for my hair.
Oh.
So that's something that's also very important.
Oh.
What else? Clothes. Korea has clothes. I mean,
he's
dressed up.
Yeah.
Korea, but my body type is very different than Korean girls' body type. In terms of shirts, it's easy to get my size here, but pants, no. Because my body's a little bit rounder. So I have to bring my own pants because I know that's going to fit me. I'm not going to find pants here.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's very important to know your body type and what you need to bring with you.
Oh.
Okay. Another thing is, okay, this sounds weird, but protein powder.
Protein powder?
No, if you work out.
Yeah.
Because I work out.
Yeah.
And protein powder, they have it here in Korea, but it's very expensive.
Oh, compared to USA.
Yeah, unless you have a Costco membership to go to Costco here, you're not going to get it very easily.
Oh.
So I brought my own protein powder because I knew it was going to be difficult. So if you're someone that likes to work out and want to keep your muscles, bring protein powder.
It sounds
so random, but you don't realize how important it is once you get here.
Yeah.
So I brought a huge container.
Oh.
The next one, okay, this sounds really, this is actually just me. So it might not affect other people. Toothpaste.
Yeah.
Because I use a special toothpaste.
What kind of?
I have sensitive gum. So it bleeds very easily.
Uh-huh.
So I need a toothpaste that's not very
strong.
Yeah, very harsh.
So
it's hard to explain, but I need to use certain special toothpaste for my teeth.
Uh-huh.
So I was like, okay, Korea's not gonna have it. So I brought a whole lot of toothpaste with me. So Korea does have toothpaste, but if you have special needs, bring your own stuff. Because you're not always going to get anything here.
Very useful tips.
You don't know until you get here.
Yeah.
Like, oh man, I don't have this here.
Yeah.
Deodorant?
Huh?
Deodorant. Koreans don't use deodorant. The stick that you put underneath your armpit.
Deodorant. Yeah.
Koreans don't use that because Koreans don't stink.
But
us foreigners, we use it.
Yeah.
And I would suggest if you have to use a special one, bring your own. So there's some deodorant that helps you not to sweat too much.
Uh-huh.
So, because there's some people that sweat a lot, and the deodorant can help you not sweat too much. that's a very special deodorant. Sometimes you have to order online or go to a store and look for it. So that I would suggest people bring it with them.
But is it impossible to buy deodorant in Korea?
So now, like 10 years ago, it was impossible.
Impossible, yeah.
But now there's a lot of foreigners here. Yeah. It's very common to find. I've seen deodorant in the store, but it's not the ones I would use. It's like the name brands is like,
maybe it's powerful.
It's not that great. Yeah, it's like it's not strong. it's one that I would not use because I use Dove. That's the brand I use, and that works for me. So I haven't found that in Korea. So I had to bring my own. So I brought a lot just to prepare. Let's see. And then the last one is tea. Okay, this sounds weird because tea? I know just tea, drinking tea. It sounds weird because this is Asia, and Asia is known for their tea. Mm-hmm. But you guys, your tea is so boring. Your tea is so boring because you guys don't have a lot of flavor. Like I go to the store and it's the green tea, and they're just like the brown rice tea.
Yeah, I know.
That's it, and it's like maybe there's like an orange flavor, and that's it. There's no other flavor. And I like to change my tea because I get bored with food. I get bored when I drink something the same thing. So I like to have a lot of different flavor, and it was really hard. There's not a lot of flavor, so I regret not bringing the tea that I like to Korea, because in my head, this is Asia. They have a lot of tea. Bring your own tea. I know it sounds so random. I'm a tea drinker and it sounds random.
But you better go to China.
Yeah, exactly. It sounds so, because I like tea with vanilla flavor. Mm-hmm. I drink vanilla chai tea. Mm-hmm. It's one of my favorite. I miss it so much and I wish I brought it with me. So it sounds random. Yeah, like if you're a tea drinker like me, like a special flavor, bring your own tea. I know. So these are the tips that I have for you. This sounds so random. But listen, until you get here, you're gonna wish you listened to my tips. So follow those tips.
But you must be very useful. Yeah, I think so.
So that's the part one of what to bring with you to Korea when you're planning to move here. We're also gonna do part two on Joe's channel. So head up to his channel to check out the next part of the next part, which is let's see. What to bring and not to bring. Stuff that's expensive here and stuff that's cheap here. So that's going to be part two on June's channel. Before we go, I also want to talk about three things. So if you are moving to Korea, there's three things to consider. And that was the three things I considered when I moved here. Location.
Location.
Yeah, location is very important because you can live somewhere that's cheap, but it's so far from all the action. So then you have to rely on the train or taxi. Because after midnight, there's the midnight bus. But after midnight, not a lot of buses, and there's no subway. So you have to spend a lot of money catching a taxi to go back home. So for me, when I moved here, I told myself I wanted to be near Hyundai. So that way that I could have fun and not have to worry about how do I get home. So that's how I end up in Sinchon. It's only a 12-minute walk from Hyundai. So it's very easy for me. So that's something to consider. But if you stay near the action, it's gonna cost you more money. I paid a lot of money, but it's worth it. So that's something to consider, location. Another thing is budgeting. Korea itself is cheap, but because it's so cheap, people spend money like water. Oh, it's so cheap. Oh, this is cheap. Let me buy this, let me buy that. And then all of a sudden your money's gone. So budget, trying to figure out different ways to not spend too much money, different ways to save. And there's a lot of stuff for foreigners to save money. So look for those things. And then the last thing is the nightlife. Once again, everything's so cheap that I see a lot of people spend money on alcohol.
Yeah.
You know, soju's so cheap. Soju's like less than $3, but yet, after you've been buying food and you're eating this and you're drinking that, all of a sudden you spend $40 in one night. So just that goes hand in hand with the budget. And when you go out, try to make sure you stay with the budget and not go too crazy because everything's cheap. So that's part one. Watch out for part two.
Okay.